Yeah, we as filmmakers always search and look for the right lens to tell our story with. And today I got a lens which is pretty unique. Where'd all the time go? Starting to I thought I would just continue this little Tech Dad series and talk about gear again. Today we talk about pretty special setup. It's a setup I've been using a while now. It's the Canon R5C with the Greatjoy 50mm T2.9 with a 1.8 squeeze. Try to wish away the So what makes anamorphic so special? If I shoot spherical glasses, I see myself using the 50mm 1.2 and the 35 1.4 the most. I feel like those are just the most true to your eye, sort of, and they just look the most cinematic in my opinion. Whereas 24 is also great, 16, like super different kind of vibe, but I feel like the most cinematic lenses of choice have to be the 35 and the 50. And that's why this lens is so special, because it kind of combines both. Because it combines the 35 and the 50, and you get a wilder field of view, you have to squeeze, you lose a bit of headroom. So it's not as close as a 50, it's more like 35. So that's what you have to keep in mind if you buy anamorphic lenses. Keep in mind that 35 doesn't equal 35 on a spherical glass, it's much wider. Yeah, you don't have autofocus using that lens, which in my opinion isn't too bad, because yeah, it adds another layer. You also have quite a bit of distortion going on in the edges. Going for a bit of a different look and have imperfections is a great choice. Yeah, who is this lens for? I think it's for people who want to make their videos more cinematic, who want to make their videos feel like movies, and yeah, just want to create unique images. I feel like pointing this lens at everything which I see, and I'm like, what the heck? It's like a movie. Probably because it's still underused in the filmmaker space on YouTube, so you don't see like too many people running around with that. But I found myself enjoying this lens a lot, and honestly, if I have the chance to shoot, most of the time I will shoot it. I will use it. Isn't the best option for low light, but it's just so artistic. I love the look. I love the look coming out of that. So anamorphic lenses, it's a big topic, definitely a big recommendation. That's why I'm doing this video. Why does anamorphic lenses, why do they look so pleasing to the eye? A common answer I heard is like, our eye is also pretty wide, and we have like a lot of stuff going on in the left and the right corner of our eyes, so it's pretty engaging to see like, I don't know, little details which you wouldn't see on a 50 1.2, for example. So that's a great explanation. I think that makes sense. Yeah, if you want to get a similar look like me, feel free to check out my LUTs. They are good. See you guys soon. Here's to many nights under the stars, wherever you